name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to maintain your seed crystals, which is essentially a way for you to strategically select which crystals you want to grow further and which crystals you are ready to discard at a very, very early stage in the crystal growth process. So for this experiment, you're going to need some deionized water. You're going to need some saturated alum solution. I am using this one because I keep adding deionized water into a mixture of alum crystals that I'm always willing to discard of. And when I still have crystals in the bottom, it tells me that my solution is saturated. So when I'm using this solution, I know that I will not be redissolving my crystals as I prepare them to go further. Then that petri dish that contained my original grow solution is now in a far more advanced stage of crystal growth. And in this one, I can see that there are small crystals and large crystals forming. I want to carefully select the large crystals so that they may grow even larger in the coming days. So for this experiment, I am going to need another petri dish, which means the cap and the base. And I'm also going to use a tweezer that will allow me to very carefully move my crystals from one container to the next. In the lid of my second petri dish, I will pour a small amount of water so that it covers the bottom completely. This will help me rinse my solution. And then in the base of my second petri dish, I will pour some of my saturated alum solution. And now I am ready. I will take my tweezer, get very close to my crystal, select the large ones that I would like to keep, pick it up, place it in my petri dish lid with the deionized water in it. I will move it around to rinse every part of it, and then very quickly place it inside the petri dish base that contains the saturated alum solution. I would like to pick at least 3 to 5 crystals that will grow even further. The more crystals we pick, the more competition each crystal will have for additional growth. So we want to optimize the growth process while maintaining a good chance of at least some of those crystals being ready for our large crystal growth. I will take my second crystal, place it into the deionized water, and then transfer it into the grow solution. And I will repeat it 3 more times. We want to place these crystals quite far from each other so that there is no accidental mingling of crystals or the opportunity for the crystals to grow on top of each other. If your crystal is large but seems like a twin, which means that 2 crystals seem to grow on top of each other, it's best to discard those crystals at this stage. I have selected 5 crystals in my grow solution, and at this point, I can take the lid of my original crystal growth mixture, place it on top, and then set my newly separated crystals apart so that they can grow undisturbed for another couple days.